According to an article from The Atlantic, June 2015, over the past 4 decades, the number of children with a parent in custody has risen to nearly 3 million, which it's also shown. Incarceration of mothers can have an effect on their children, whether they are separated immediately after birth or they are raised by the mother. In the next few minutes, I will tell you about separating children from their incarcerated mothers, then the nursery programs that prisons offer, and how raising the child in a prison nursery can affect the mother. First, I'll talk about separating a child from their incarcerated mother. The separation of a mother in prison from the child can have an impact on both of them. A child can be affected when they are separated from their incarcerated mother immediately after birth. AMA Journal of Ethics 2013 writes, for infants, maternal separation at birth can lead to multifaceted, severe emotional and behavioral problems in later life, including low self-esteem, less successful peer relationships, and difficulty coping with life stressors. A study conducted by Renee Spitz, which is explained in The Atlantic, showed how being in a foundling home can impact the child. The article wrote, his findings revealed developmental gaps. Even the oldest children who were in the foundling home that were between 18 and 30 months old were incontinent. Few could walk, talk, or eat without assistance. Separation not only affects the child, but also the mother that is in prison. The Atlantic, June 2015, explained a study by Joseph Carlson, which said 50% of mothers who had been separated from their newborns had returned to custody. Separation from a child can impact, can have an impact on the way mothers behave while they're incarcerated and even after they're out of prison. Now that you know the effects of separating a mother from their child, I can tell you about the programs that prisons offer. Some prisons are starting to offer nursery programs for mothers in prison so that they don't have to be separated from their babies. Infants in Orange from Hastings Women's Law Journal writes, as of 2010, only 9 states have prison nurseries. The oldest prison nursery in the United States is the Bedford Hills Correctional Facility in New York City. And Nebraska has the second oldest. All of these nurseries in the United States only allow children to stay until they are a year or 18 months old. In other countries, it's very common to have nursery programs in prisons. Germany, Mexico, Kenya, and Canada are some examples of these countries. The nursery programs in these countries allow mothers to keep their children with them until they are 3 to 6 years old. Now that you are aware of the nursery programs that are available in prisons, I will share what it's like to raise a child in a nursery. Raising a child in a prison nursery can have an impact on the incarcerated mothers and their child. When a mother raises her child in a prison nursery, it can have a positive impact on her. According to The Atlantic, June 2015, research has suggested that women who participate in the Bedford Hills Correctional Facility programs are significantly less likely to return to prison than inmates in the general population. A story done by ABC News 2014 also said 33% of mothers separated from their babies returned to prison, whereas only 10% who keep their babies returned to prison. Now that you know about prison nurseries and separating children from incarcerated mothers, you can see the effects that these can have on both the mother and the child. Incarcerated mothers that are separated from their babies or are raising their children in prison nurseries can impact them a lot. All of us are someone's son or daughter, and the things our parents decide to do can have a big effect on our lives.